will Texas look like 100 years in the future? What are we doing now that will have the greatest significance then? Where will our most basic resources come from? Food, water, energy? One thing we know is that the climate will be different. We also know the sea level will be higher. We know it because it is happening right now, right here in Texas. You just have to look very closely and be very, very patient.
Based on tide gauges that we've had out there since the early 1900s in some cases, we're seeing about 1 to 2 feet in 100 years. That translates into about 2.5 millimeters per year up to 6.5 millimeters per year. So it's a substantial rate, a bit higher than the global rate.
Depending on where you are in Texas, the sea level is rising at different rates.
There's higher rates on the upper Texas coast. Rates decrease down into the Corpus Christi area and decrease even further down in the Padre Island National Seashore and increase a little bit down near the Rio Grande Delta area.
In March of 2010, the HARTE Research Institute for Gulf of Mexico Studies and Texas A&M University in Corpus Christi hosted an international conference on sea level rise in the Gulf of Mexico.
This is a one-way street. Sea level doesn't just suddenly go down again. It will continue that upward trend and continue rising for the foreseeable future. The question is, just how much is sea level going to rise? Antarctica and Greenland hold a central position in the sea level rise debate because the ice sheets hold a great deal of ice that could melt and become part of the oceans and would raise the ocean. And this is the biggest uncertainty that we have about sea level rise. There are other contributions to future sea level rise, which are the thermal expansion of the oceans and the contribution from mountain glaciers around the world. But those things are relatively predictable compared to the uncertainty that we have over Antarctica and Greenland, the big ice sheets.
Antarctica and Greenland are a long way from Texas. What's going on here, right now?
Summers are just as hot as they've always been. What we are seeing is changes in winter temperatures. Our winters have been getting warmer since about 1991. Almost 6 to 7 degrees warmer in the winter. That's pretty significant.
These temperature readings come from the routine sampling that Texas Parks and Wildlife has done since 1974.
With our net samples, they gather number of species caught.
I get a fin clip also on that one.
The size of the species.
It's over a meter long.
And they collect environmental measurements along with the sample.
Temperature is 27.8.
It's one of the most comprehensive monitoring programs in the world.
With climate change, there are winners
Gorgeous.
And losers.
Flounder have declined. They're winter spawners. And they seem to require cold winters to produce more juveniles. The warmer the winter, the fewer flounder juveniles we see.
There goes.
Other species are increasing.
We're seeing more tropical species, in particular gray snapper. They'll die below about 50 degrees water temperature. And since about 91, we've had almost no winters get that cold, and their population has increased exponentially.
We are also seeing changes with the migration of plant species.
Black mangrove. Rockport used to be the northern limit, but But since these warmer winters, they have moved northward along the coast. They're as far up as Palacios now. There's a red mangrove, which is characteristic of the Caribbean, and we're starting to see some areas become populated with red mangroves.
What will climate change and sea level rise mean for Texas in the future? Scientists predict that in 100 years, the sea level could rise 3 feet. That would significantly alter our coastline.
The current sea level rise is not a situation that humans have faced in modern times. That is, since we started to create built environments, cities and bulkheads and things along the coast, sea level has never been rising in that period. Sea level is going to rise between a meter and two in the next 100 years. We actually can't change that at this point. So what we're going to have to do is adapt to it. And there are two ways to do it. One is to try to defend the way the Netherlands has historically over the last 1,000 years. Or you can move and retreat from it. And I have to say that we're not going to defend most places on the coast because it's simply going to be too hard and too expensive. So we will defend some places, but we will in fact retreat from most places at the coast over the next century. Historically, sea level has gone up and down over geologic time. Before people built cities and bridges and things, the natural environment just moved. But now we're in the way. If we're going to have natural environments like fringe swamps and marshes and lowland forests, where are they going to move to? We're going to have to plan that. And the question is, what are we going to do with the stuff we leave behind?
I understand it's difficult for people to put a lot of faith or trust in things that they can't put their finger on.
The temperature is 27.1.
And so that's why I often fall back to the actual measurements. Don't emphasize the computer modeling or the projections or the theory. Just look at the facts that we have actually observed to have occurred over the last 100 years. And it's obvious that we need to do things differently during the next 100 years, and that takes planning.